In today's session, we'll learn about design procedure for cotter joint. This cotter joint, also known as socket and spigot joint. So here it consists of three parts. The red color part is cotter. Inside this socket, there is another part that is spigot end, shown by blue color. The third part is socket. The cotter joint is used for tensile load as well as for compressive load. So the major dimensions are diameter of rod denoted as small d. Here load P applied to both the sides of cotter joint. Here socket is a hollow part, therefore D1 is the outer diameter of socket, D2 is internal diameter of socket. Now this internal diameter of socket is equal to external diameter of spigot, which is D2. Here D3 is the diameter of spigot collar, D4 is the diameter of socket collar. Here B is the mean width of cotter. Here cotter is the part which is having slope on one side and it is straight on other side. Here A is the distance from end of slot to end of spigot rod. And here C is the thickness of socket collar, and here thickness of cotter we denoted as small t. Now let us analyze types of failures occur during application of cotter joint. So here I make a table of various stresses induced in cotter joint. So there are 3 tensile stress, 4 shear stress, 3 crushing stress and 1 bending stress. Here minimum area of cotter joint is diameter of a rod, that is small d. So the first failures occurs at minimum area, that is tensile stress in rod, which is equal to load P divided by cross section area of a rod, that is pi by 4 d square. The next failures occur due to tensile stress at diameter of spigot end. So the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is pi by 4 d square minus d2 multiplied by thickness small t. The next tensile stress is at outside diameter of socket end, and the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is pi by 4 d1 square minus d2 square minus thickness small t into D1 minus D2. So these are 3 tensile stresses in cotter joint. Now the next stress is shear stress. So the failure occurred due to shear stress at diameter of spigot end collar, and the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is pi D2 into thickness D1. The next failures occur due to double shear stress at distance from end of slot to end of spigot. So the formula is load P divided by area of cross section. The next failures occur due to double shear stress at thickness of socket collar. So the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is 2 into D4 minus D2 into thickness of socket collar, that is capital C. The next failures occur due to direct shear stress at width of cotter, and the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is 2 into width of cotter B into thickness small t. So these are 4 shear stresses in cotter joint. Now the next stress is crushing stress. So failures occur due to crushing stress at diameter of spigot end, and the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is diameter of spigot end D2 multiplied by thickness small t. Next failures occur due to crushing stress at outside diameter of spigot end collar, and the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is pi by 4 D3 square minus D2 square. Next failures occur due to crushing stress at outside diameter of socket collar, and the formula is load P divided by area of cross section, that is D4 minus D2 multiplied by thickness small t. So these are 3 crushing stresses in cotter joint. Now the next stress is bending stress. So the failure occurred due to bending stress in width of cotter. So the formula is load P into 2D4 plus D2 divided by 4TB square. Here T is the thickness of cotter and B is the mean width of cotter. So there are total 11 types of stresses in cotter joint, where 3 of tensile stress, 4 types of shear stress, 3 types of crushing stress and 1 type of bending stress.